Hey everyone, so this is going to be a quick and simple tutorial on vending machine basics. As you can see, there's three vending machines. Each one of them does something slightly different. So let's go to the first one. As you can see, there's three items. So just take your pick, basically. Just like you would see in a game back in the day. The second machine, let me show you the difference. Again, you can just take your pick. Except this one is set to shut off after you receive your item. Now to show you what is up with the last machine, I'm just going to restart the game because it needs a little bit more time for the explanation. This last machine is more along the likes of what you'd find in a search and destroy game. And I'm not going to be explaining how to do this one in this particular tutorial, but just real quick, I want to show you what it does. Basically, you've only got one item to work with, and as you can see, it's the only one that actually asks for currency. And then also it's set to turn off on its own after a predetermined amount of time, exactly like happens in the search and destroy maps that you've seen. Well, the focus of this tutorial is actually going to be on these first two machines, on how to make these. I wanted to make that the focus because it's a simple, basic tutorial for people that maybe haven't used the vending machine that often or are not too familiar with it. Don't concern yourself with this one right now. I just wanted to show you, to give you like more of a full demonstration of what is possible with the vending machine. And there's more too, but right now I'm gonna just show you how to set these machines up. Alrighty, so for the first machine, these two are actually very, very similar in terms of settings. So let's go ahead and I'm just gonna delete them both so that we can just recreate it from scratch. Hopefully that method is simple for people to follow. So what we need to do is we just go to our menu, and we'll ignore the last one, just to completely ignore it. So go to your menu, just pull up your creative menu, and up there on top, go to the creative tab, and then after that, go to your devices, and that's where your vending machine is located. And details pertaining to the vending machine. Vending machine allows you to make items available for purchase during games. Place the device, then drop items in front of it to register them. So let's equip two of them, or if you want, you can copy and paste. So let's go ahead and just equip one for now. Sometimes with similar settings, it's a lot easier to copy and paste. Let's just throw it there. And now let's go up to it and let's pick the items that we want in it. You can have up to three items, one to three items. Let's see. They don't have to be weapons, they can be consumables, but I just thought that sticking to weapons would make it easier. Let's just go all shotguns, all purple shotguns. So let's equip that and that and that. All right, so next, in order to give it to the machine, again on top, you see My Island, Creative, and Play. Go to play, and then you can see there's a way to drop it. Just simply stand as close as possible to the machine that you want it dropped into and click the corresponding button for dropping the item. So for me it's an X, for you it might be something else depending on what platform you're on. And then I'm going to do the same with the next two. Sometimes it doesn't take it. If it doesn't take it, just pick it right back up and put it right back in. Remember to stand really close to the machine, and you don't want to stand close to other machines because it might get sucked up in that machine instead, and then there's no way to remove the item once it's in, so you'd have to actually start all over. If that made no sense to you, just ignore it, but basically stand as close to the machine as possible and just drop. That is our third item right there, so then exit out. So as you can see, we've got basically, if you remember previous seasons when there were vending machines in game, this is how they looked. The difference is that they would lock up. And I'm copying this and I'm going to paste it over here. On the other hand, just keep in mind you could always just throw down another instance, but I'll just do it this way for now since I already put the weapons inside. We'll just stick with those. As for settings with regards to this, this is as simple as it gets because we're just going to keep all the defaults. We're not going to change anything. Okay, I wanted to show you this on purpose because this is what you get if you just use all the defaults. So I'm going to push OK and leave it at that. this one, in order to have it shut down after use, we actually only need to change two settings. Go to this setting right here, which is disable when receiving from. Pick a channel. I haven't used channel 1, so I'm going to pick channel 1, but it could be any of these up to channel 100, looks like. So I'm going to pick channel 1. Next thing we need to do is we need to, this setting way at the bottom, right here, it says when item spawn transmit on. We're going to set that to channel 1 as well. So basically, it's sending a signal to itself. This bottom parameter right here says transmits a signal on the selected channel when an item is spawned from the vending machine. So basically what that means is that when you ask the vending machine to give you an item and it pops out and it gets put in your inventory, that sends a signal on channel 1. So since up here we set channel 1 to have the machine disabled, once the item is given to us, at the same time that tells the machine to turn off. I hope that makes sense. Push OK to save it. And now let's see if these two work. Start game to test it. This one's pretty straightforward. I don't see it. I see it really hard to make a mistake with this one. Alright, since we're not, you don't really change any of the settings. And for this one, remember, we hope that it's basically going to turn off after we make our selection. So, I'm going to pick this. And it worked. Woohoo! And again, we are not going to concern ourselves with the implementation of this one just yet. That is going to be found in my Search and Destroy Map tutorial part 2, Vending Machines. So if you want to check that out, go for it. The reason I put it in there is because in Search and Destroy Maps, the usage of vending machines is done in a very specific way. It's almost like you use currency to buy an item, and it's a single item, and it's just very different from the way that vending machines have been traditionally set up in Fortnite. So I hope that helped somebody out there. You know what to do if you liked it. You know what to do if you want to see more. And I'll see you later. I hope you have a great day. Well, I'm at the dead. I'm so impressed.